Cumpleaños feliz, cumpleaños feliz, cumpleaños, cumpleaños, cumpleaños feliz.
Hey Emmy, happy 22nd birthday. I know this is kind of late, but I was so busy today and all that, and I said I would try to make time for do this. I know you're not on Facebook or any social media, but I put out a birthday wish for you on Facebook. And so this is the video I was talking to you about at work. I mean, for so long. And so it's finally happening. What I'm going to do is sing you the birthday song, of course, which I hope to sing to you at work tomorrow if you're there. And of course, like I promised you, since I know you love this show so much, I got this. Jeopardy. I'm playing this for you. Jeopardy for the PlayStation 3. The PS3 is already waiting to be used. Therefore, I hope you had a great celebration today, and hopefully we'll get to go in the media room tomorrow. I'll get to go in there with you, so that way we can look at this with everybody. Some people at work who know you can look at this video I made for you. So before I get into the song, I'm gonna say a few things. First off, I'm very thankful that I met you Friday, August 28th. Well, not only that, I'm thankful I picked the place to work at where I am right now, because if I would have picked something else, I never would have met you at all, or anyone else I know there. Yeah. Also, I do have a gift for you. Hold on a second. I printed you this picture of Austin Dillon's number 3 Bass Pro Shop NRA Museum Chevy. The one where he had the car that he ran when he flipped at Daytona in July. Scared the crap out of me. No, that was when I cried. No, it scared me. It scared and worried me so much that I did cry. No matter how tough I am, the things like that can make me cry. And that's exactly what happened. I was so scared. Like I told you when I first met you, it was my first time having a driver I root for in NASCAR in 15 years as a fan flip a car. Not the way I wanted to have my first favorite driver, my first ever driver I liked flip, but oh well. I didn't think that would ever happen to me, but sadly it did. But anyway, also after I'm making this video, I'm going to see if I can do make you a card, an online printable card. And decorated a lot of stuff you like Austin Dillon, Ty Dillon, the Pittsburgh Pirates, the Pittsburgh Steelers, the Pittsburgh Penguins, and of course the Cleveland Cavaliers, because there's no Pittsburgh team in the NBA. I'm going to try as much as I can. So here's what I'm going to say. I'm just glad I picked the right place to work at. I'm not going to say the name on here, because I don't want to get in trouble with people who work there. Oh yeah, and also, we already made a lot of great memories together. Like, on Tuesday, September 15th, when you were subbing in D4, you rubbed my back. I asked you to, and you did that for me. That was very nice of you. The day we celebrated Austin's a great weekend at Charlotte a couple weeks ago, that's why I came back from the Ricky Martin concert. Oh, and he won the Xfinity race Friday night, and what I spent a 7th in the cup race on Sunday afternoon, what was supposed to be a Saturday night, but it rained. I'm glad we got to celebrate that with you. And not only that, as a birthday present, you know, remember I bought you that Coke because to celebrate? Well, I'm going to buy you another one tomorrow for your birthday, as long as the vending machine's not out. And I hope you're there tomorrow. And also I would like to meet your boyfriend. What's his name? I think it's Jake, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'd like to meet him sometime, and hopefully, if he's fine with it, you and him can come over here to North Ridgeville, and we can hang out sometime and watch a NASCAR race, as long as a Dillon's in it, and also a Spurs game on Fox Sports Southwest, and they just won. I just finished watching their game on their channel, Fox Sports Southwest. It was a 91-79 victory, I believe. But if the Cavs are playing on the same night on their channel, Fox Sports Ohio, we'll go back and forth between the Spurs channel and the Cavs channel here, just to make it fair for you. You're just like some other best friends I have in my life. You're like a sister to me, Emily. I can tell you almost anything and any time. And if I get upset at work, and as long as you're there, I'll go to you. And I hope you can do the same for me. Don't forget I love you, and you're one of my few heroes at work. All my heroes at work that I have, I have a few of them. All of them are females, of course. You'll know tomorrow. I'll tell you tomorrow if you're there. So without further ado, let's get to your song. I want to make sure I'm prepared in time. That way I don't get caught off guard. Okay, here we go. Happy 22nd birthday to my BFF from work, Emily, Katherine Ravis. Met her Friday, August 28th of early. Share this year during my very first day there. Talk to her about NASCAR and the Spurs too. And well, and my 21 year life story. So I have to turn it down a little bit because I have some sleepy people here. There we go. On Halloween this past Friday, I hung out with her and my awesome friend Sean, top and rose in one of the departments. We had a group hug at the buses. Remember that Halloween Eve and all both of you were in there? And I came to see you, and when I was getting on my bus, we shared a group hug, only because I kind of forced it, and they've asked me. But at least you guys were nice enough to hug me back. That made me feel good. Here we go again.
On Tuesday, September 15th of this year, I came and visited her in a department, and when she rubbed my back for me, after I asked her to do so since everyone else was doing it to each other. My best friend for life until the day I die, hope your wishes come true, and that it's the best birthday. One of her best features is that she's a huge sports fan, a Pittsburgh Pirates fan and baseball, Pittsburgh Steelers and football, Penguins and hockey, Cavs and basketball, and Austin Dillon and Ty Dillon and NASCAR courtesy of me. I hope to have you over at my house soon to watch a race with one of the Dillons in it, or for a Spurs game on Fox Sports Southwest, and the Cavs if they're playing on the same night.
I almost screwed up there. If I screw up, I'm gonna be pissed. I thought I had a sing here, but I don't. It's an instrumental pause until 3 minutes 17 seconds. This is actually a kind of a confusing song to write your own song to. Right, a confusing melody to write your own song to, if you ask me. I've had trouble with it before. Alright, now, here we go.
As a best friend and brother to you, I love you so much with all my heart. And I'm glad we have two things in common with each other, the Dillon brothers in Jeopardy. I'm so thankful I started working where I'm at right now. Otherwise I wouldn't have met you like I did. Thank you so much for being my best friend and also being in my life.
There you go, Emily. There you go. In case you're wondering what that song was to, that's from Crash Bandicoot, the second game called Cortex Strikes Back. It's from the jungle levels, Turtle Woods, the pits, and Night Fighter, I believe. Night Fighter, Night Flight. I have to look at the videos of the game again. The first one's level 1, of course. The second one is level 4. I think the last one is level 23. So I hope you enjoyed that. Without further ado, let's get to your birthday game. This is Jeopardy. Okay, Emily, here we go. Here's your birthday game, which of course I made it. I know I did this just for you. I know you love this show. Jeopardy for the PlayStation 3. I don't know why we can't enter a name for you, but I try to make it look like you, but okay. All right, here we go. This is it. Here we go. Hope we can make you the Jeopardy champion on your birthday. Mute this computer volume. That way I don't hear no. I turned off all audio. And the computer on my phone, that way there's no background noises in the video. Here we go! I think it's a 2011-2012 opening, I believe. This is Jeopardy! Just like 11-12, I believe. My first time ever playing this game.
Please welcome our contestant.
Emily Katherine Ravis. That's who she is. That might be too loud.
And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Yeah!
Thank you, Johnny Gilbert. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. Let's take you right now into the Jeopardy round. Clues are worth $200 to $1,000 in these categories. Literary geography.
I hope they're easy.
Pets. Jazz nickname.
Oh, yeah.
Do the math.
Oh, God. This is not the Mike Watch Barron's commercial. Fish proper.
And USA Today's memorable quote makers. Player one, start us.
Jazz nickname for 200.
Edward Ellington.
Oh, I know this.
It's player one.
What is Duke? That's easy.
Player one, back to you.
400.
Next select, Charlie Parker.
Oh, I can't remember that one.
Here's the correct response.
What is it, Alex?
Bird.
Bird Parker. Oh.
We return to you.
I forgot this multiple choice, but although that shouldn't be that way because this is Jeopardy. Not who wants to be a millionaire.
Let's be.
Okay, I'm going to try a guess.
Player one.
I'll try, what is, Dizzy? No, Sunny? Damn! Not Sunny.
Any other takers?
Multiple choice makes it so difficult. If you don't, especially don't know the answer.
Here's the correct response. Dizzy.
Oh, I was going for that. I would have been right. Oh, my God, I'm so stupid. 800.
Thomas Wright Waller.
I have no time. I have a little bit. One. Jumbo? Aww. God damn!
Any other takers?
This is bad. I already know what the Wii game is like this.
Here's the correct response. Fats.
Fats. Shit. Okay.
We return to you.
I guess 1,000.
Adderley.
Yeah, I'm going to try this again.
Let's hear it, player one.
What is... Nope. Wait. What is Junior?
Sorry.
Oh, my God. This is bad.
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response?
Uh-oh.
Okay, player three. Right.
Damn. We had to wear our work cut out for us, Emily.
Player 3 has control. 39xy divided by 3.
Oh, shit, I don't know this.
This.
I can't do this kind of math. Like, what? Why the hell would they put the alphabet into it?
It's player 3.
Oh, she got it wrong, too.
Anyone else?
So it's not 39x. What chance? I can't remember. I wasn't paying attention, but whatever she said, that's not it.
We're talking about 13Y.
13Y.
You get to pick again, player three.
Pets.
With more than 70 million living with American households, this is the most common house pet in the United States.
I think I might know this. Let's not get locked out.
Player one.
What is a dog?
No, that's not right.
Damn! Not dog.
Anyone else?
It's a cat, isn't it? Damn, Emily, off to a shitty-ass start.
We're talking about the cat.
Yep, I just picked the wrong one.
Player three, pick again. This type of parrot that bears the name of a South American river can get used to cooler temperatures.
Here, I guess we can try.
Player one.
Yeah, I'm gonna try this. What is a piranha? I had a bad feeling about that.
Any other takers?
Player three. Amazon.
Right.
I'm so stupid. We need to get back in this, Emily.
Player three, you pick again, please. Often advertised in comic books, see these are actually brine shrimp in suspended animation.
I'm not even going to try it. And remember, I'm not playing for myself, Emily. I'm playing for you.
Here's the response we were looking for. Sea monkeys.
Sea monkeys.
Player three, choose again. William Howard Taft was the last prez to have one of these grazing at the White House. Her name was Pauline Wayne.
I'm bringing
in. Player one?
We need to get back into this. Here. What is a cow? Yes! Oh, thank you, God. We needed that.
Okay, let's get back into this. Player one, you make the next
1,000. Oh my God, we needed that, Emily. Thank you, God.
One of the oldest domesticated dog breeds is the Saluki, the royal dog of this ancient people.
I have no clue. Okay, I'm going to fix the camera. I'm going to move it to the left more.
We're talking about the Egyptians.
Okay, the camera look.
Choose again.
No, let's hold on a second. Wait. Pause it. Wait a minute. Hang on. That's the best I can do with the camera. Okay, if I don't pause, I'm gonna run out of time. Alright. Finish the proverb for 200.
Too many cooks. Let's hear it.
I'm gonna try it. Too many cooks. Oh yeah, no, it spoiled the broth. Yes, that was easy. I knew that one.
You again, player one.
400.
You can't judge a book.
That's easy.
Yes, player one.
By its cover. Now we're getting it, Emily. Now we're getting it.
Player one. Nothing ventured?
Don't know. Not ringing in.
Here's the correct response. Nothing gained.
Nothing gained. Okay.
You again, player one.
800.
He who laughs last. Let's hear it, player one.
He who laughs last. Yeah, we can look shit up. Okay, we can look shit up. This will help us get back into this game. I'm going to cheat here. He who laughs last. Oh my God, what the hell is it? Anybody who says I was cheating to do this is gonna get as good. I mean, I'm probably cheating, but whoever says any stupid shit that I'm doing this is gonna get blocked. It's gonna get blocked. Okay, I think I got it. What is last best?
Yep.
Now we're getting back into it.
Layer one.
1,000.
Man cannot live.
Okay.
Okay, player one.
Pause. This will get you out of the hole, Emily, if it gets correct. Man cannot live. Without love. Without love. Oh, I picked the wrong one again.
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct response?
Oh, I know what it was. I'm by bread alone.
Let's hear it, player two.
By if he's left alone? No!
Anyone else care to try to come up with a correct
answer? Oh, I think I got it. By bread alone. By bread alone.
Let's hear it, player.
I know what it is.
You got it.
Damn. That's okay.
Three, you start us off. Add 20, 21, and 22. Multiply by 3, and you get this.
Nope. No, no.
Here's what we were looking for. 189.
189. Damn.
Select again.
Somebody pick a different category.
Negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 2 times negative 2 equals this.
Yeah, I'm going to try it.
Player 1.
Negative 4. Negative. Negative. Negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4. Hang on, check. Times negative 2. Hey, let me go to a calculator or something. Wait a minute. Alright. No, it is 4. Yeah, I got the Yahoo calculator. We can do this math. Times negative 4. I got the Yahoo. I got the Google calculator. Excuse me. Times negative 2. Times neg. Wait. What did that say? Times negative 2. Whoops. No. Wrong one. Alright. Times negative 2. 64. What is 64? I got it. There you go.
Player 1.
Now look into the math.
If 7x plus 5 equals 40, x equals this.
No clue.
Yes, player 3.
No, thank God we didn't try it.
Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this?
No, we'll try it on the next one if it's possible.
Here's the response we were looking for.
What is it? 5. Single. Damn. We still get to pick, Emily.
From the Greek for stretch, it's the term for the longest side of a right triangle.
I thought it was going to be another problem with numbers, but I guess not. Damn.
It's player 3. That's correct. All right, let's get back into this. Player 3 has control. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
What's the category?
It's player 1.
Okay, I'm going to look this up. Gorbachev. Oh, I got it. Who is Ronald Reagan?
Yes.
Yep.
Player 1.
I'll keep going.
Command of
400.
It takes a village to raise a child.
It takes a village to raise a child. We're gonna try to run through this whole damn category to get out of the hall. It takes a village to raise a child. Oh, no, I didn't want that. Who said that? Oh, I got this. Who is Hillary Clinton? Yes!
You again.
600.
People, I just want to say, you know, can we all get along?
Okay, let's do
player
it.
One?
I'm just Googling the quote. I have to do this. This is the only way we're going to get back in this game, MA. People. Too bad we can't pause during the first and second edition on the PS1. I just want to say, you know, can we all get along? Oh, I got it. Who is Rodney King? Yeah, baby, out of the hole. About damn time.
You again, player one. Keep hope alive.
Okay, here we go.
Player one.
Keep hope alive. I got it. Who is Jesse Jackson? Yes! We'll get in second place if we get this right.
How do we know when irrational exuberance has unduly escalated asset values?
This will put us in second place. Let me see. What does this say? How do we know? How do we know it? Unduly okay, let me see here. Who said this? Okay, I got it. Who is Alan Greenspan? Second place is yours, Demi. Second place is yours.
You get to pick again.
All right, this is the last category. Literary geography with 200.
In chapter 8 of this novel, Atlanta is very exhilarating and temporarily even better than Tara.
Don't know.
Let's hear it, player 2.
Gone with the wind. Gago Shibago. No, I'm just kidding.
Player 2. You
he's through to 400.
In the preface to the Moonstone, Vishnu commands three Brahmins in this
country
to guard the title gem night and day.
Don't know. And my camera's yellow on battery, so...
We're talking about India.
India. So after the Jeopardy round, I'll take a break and charge
Please
the camera.
Please, again, player two.
You're like,
in Pride and Prejudice, Mrs. Bennett says... The country is a vast deal pleasanter than this city.
It's 11:12 p.m., so I should finish this video in one night. Oh, player two got it wrong.
Anyone else?
-1400.
Response?
But at least you came back to second place suddenly after that whole shitty-ass start.
Player three?
If she gets it wrong, you'll be in the lead. Oh, nope, she didn't.
All right, let's get back into this. Player three has control.
Daily Double, isn't
let's
it?
Get Sarah's
assistant. Oh, no, it's the Clue Crew.
Hemingway's vivid description of Pamplona's San Fermin Festival in this 1926 novel helped make the Running of the Bulls a world-famous event.
It's the Clue Crew. I forgot that they're featured in this game for the first time ever in a Jeopardy video game. The last clue is going to belong to player 3.
Here's the correct response. The sun...
It's going to belong to player 3 because it's the daily double. It's going to belong to player 3.
$1,000 clue.
It's going to belong to you, player 3. Okay, Emily, you got a chance with me when she goes for it. You got a chance with me. How much she wagering? Got to find out. Oh, a strange wager. Here we go. Here we go. Get it wrong. Get it wrong. Get it wrong. No! Yeah, she got it wrong. You're in the lead, Emily.
Player 2 is in third place. Means, of course, player 2 will select first in Double Jeopardy.
And he will do that as soon as we come back. Alright, Emmy, welcome back. Welcome back to the 2015 22nd birthday special. The camera's fully charged. Hopefully it can stay charged for a while when we're about to start the Double Jeopardy round. We're in the lead with 2,000. Player 3 just incorrectly answered the Daily Double, which was the last clue on the Jeopardy round. She has 1,150 of her joint, and player 2 is on minus 1,400, but of course he gets to go first in Double Jeopardy. So let's do this.
And we have two Daily Doubles awaiting you in these categories.
Well, they do the award show for both rounds. On the real show, you don't do that.
City history.
They quit doing that a long time ago.
Body basics. Writers at rest. Around
I can't believe they do that in this game.
Oscar winners of yore. And the meaning of the prefix.
Okay, before player 2 selects his clue, I gotta tell you something. I didn't expect the game to do that. I bet you the Nintendo Wii version, which is similar to this, does that too. Because when they had the old board feel sound, I don't know if you remember it, Emily, when they had the boop, 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 which they got rid of altogether in the 25th season, in 2009. They used to do it for both rounds, Jeopardy and Double Jeopardy, but then middle season 14, I believe, sometime in early 1998, 1914, they quit doing it for Double Jeopardy. And then they got rid of stopped doing it altogether for both the Jeopardy round. They had Double Jeopardy for 08 or 09. Then 9-10, they brought this down here, but they don't do it for both rounds on the real show now. They do it for both rounds here, I guess. I guess that's what happened. That's what the prime example is. Just a video game. Video games aren't real. So they wouldn't do that in real life Jeopardy today. All right, let's get to this game.
Where do we begin, player 2? This Missouri city wasn't named for Scott or Janice, but for the Reverend Harris G., an early settler there.
Don't know. Oh, damn it, I was going to try it. Player 2 locked me out.
Yes.
That would have been my guess, too, but I got locked out. Damn it.
2 months before the Declaration of Independence, the Rhode Island Independence Act was signed in this city.
Hang on, I'm going to try it.
Let's hear it, player 1.
Okay, time for Google again. So nobody better, like I said on my other Jeopardy videos, I've done this. Anybody who slams me for this shit is gonna get blocked. Okay, what was it about? Rhode Island Independence Act. Hold on a second, I'm looking it up. So it's either Providence, Pawtucket, or Woonsocket. Whatever one I see on the computer will is the correct answer. Oops, hey. Oh, okay, I got it. What is Providence? Yes!
Player 1.
1200.
It was Arizona's territorial capital from 1867 to 1877, and a university was founded there in 1885. Yes, player 1.
Tuscan, Phoenix. It's either, I know it's not King, man, so it's either Tuscan or Phoenix. So I gotta... Arizona's territorial capital. Whoops. Yeah, I can't type with one hand. That's what I'm doing. I have one hand, other hand, I have a controller. Territorial capital. I'm trying to make sure I'm spelling that right. This is not like older Jeopardy games where you have to answer your answer and assume that you're going to get it correct. You have multiple choice like a torn to be a millionaire, and that's not right. Wait, what was the year from? 1867 to 1877. Oh wait, I got a minute. Territorial capital history. Wait a minute. Okay, so I'm 1867 to 1877. Okay, I think I got this. What is a Tuscan? I can't pronounce that correctly. Yes! Got it! That took a while for me to make sure. 1600.
Indianapolis was laid out in a wheel pattern inspired by this other major city some 500 miles away.
I have no idea, so I'm not gonna freaking try this shit.
Player 3?
No! Nope, not New York City.
Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this?
Whoa, well, you're the only one on the plus side. That would be kind of crazy if you're the only one for Final Jeopardy. Wait, have you just started your Double Jeopardy, so we gotta see what happens.
Here's the response we were looking for. Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C. Aw, damn. I wasn't even thinking about that. I'll finish up the category in 2000.
Jimmy with the clue.
Oh, I hate this guy.
It was uninhabited when it was chosen as a territorial capital in 1836 and named for a president who died that year.
Oh, president. Okay, president who died in 1836. Oh, wait a minute. I'll be right back. Hold on a second. I gotta put the stop my sign on the door. Wait a minute. Hold on, Emily. I'll be right back. Hold on. Okay, Emily, I'm back. Sorry for the interruption. Brief interruption. I had to go put my sign on the door to alert everybody. I was recording. I do not need to be disturbed. But who's the president of that in 1836 we were looking for? And what was the year 1836? So one of their names, whoever's the name, they'll be correct the answer. Oh, I got this. What is Madison? James Madison.
Good.
Yes! Alright, so let's finish this video. Oscar winners of yore for 400.
John Ford directed this verdant 1941 winner about a Welsh mining family.
Mm-mm. Don't know. Let's see if Claire 2 will get it right. No! Oh my
Any
god.
Other takers?
This is just like my Let's Play on the PC version of the first edition of 1998. The computer was out of it in that Let's Play. If you check out that video on my channel.
We're talking about How Green Was My Valley.
How Green Was My Valley. Let's get the hell out of there. Around the world for 400.
In 1994, Jordan signed a peace treaty with this country, ending the official state of war between them.
I don't have a clue.
We're talking about Israel.
Israel. Oh my god. This is harder than I expected.
Please pick again.
This game. Okay, I'll stay there. 800.
In 1903, Panama declared its independence from this country.
Hang on, let me turn that down a little bit. It's way too loud. I got people sleeping in my house.
We're talking about Colombia.
Colombia. Damn.
Layer 1, choose again.
Okay, 14 for Danny Green on the Spurs. 1200.
Here's Sarah.
Uh-oh.
Forgotten for centuries, this Incan royal retreat was rediscovered by Hiram Bingham in 1911.
Yeah. Trying to ring in and guess out of the three multiple choice answers is kind of a risk.
Let's hear it, player two.
Player two. Oh, he got it wrong again. Oh, it looks like you're going to be the only one from Final Jeopardy, Emily, unless the computer player the computer players get a miracle to get out of a hole. But I think it's impossible. How much?
Here's the response we were looking for. Machu Picchu.
Machu Picchu. I think they took a lesson from you at the beginning. You're off to a bad start. Now they're off to a bad start. Double Jeopardy. Let's get out of there. Body Baker's 400.
All right. Here with the clue is Sarah.
Okay.
When swallowing, the soft palate
She's cute, by
is
the
raised
way.
To keep food from entering the nasal cavity. And this flap of cartilage moves to prevent food from entering the trachea.
It's too risky to answer against multiple choice. That's not how Jeopardy should be.
Here's what we wanted. Epiglottis.
Epiglottis. I don't know shit about that.
Player one. Pick again.
Around the world, I guess. 1600. No, how fuck that. Prefix.
Hemi. Okay, player three.
Half. Okay, I get it.
Player three, make a selection, please.
Oh, no, ready to rest.
Her headstone at West Cemetery in Amherst says she was born December 10th, 1830. Called back May 15th, 1886. It's player one.
Let me see here. Rider, which rider died? Hold on a sec. Yeah, I'm looking it up again. That's the sign of the toilet flushing, sorry. May 15th, 1886. That's the easy one. I got it. Who is Emily Dickinson? Hey, go. She has your first name, Emily. Writers at rest for 800.
His grave is marked Reverend Charles Luckridge Dodson. Fell asleep January 14th, 1898. Aged 65 years.
1898.
Player one?
Okay. I think it might be Charles Dickens. I'm our Mark Twain. I know it's probably not Lewis Carroll. 1898. So what's the date we're looking for? January 14th, 1898. January 14th is what we're looking for. Okay, I got it. Who is Lewis Carroll? I would have guessed Mark Twain, but thank God I looked it up.
Layer 1, choose
1200.
Buried at the Sleepy Hollow Cemetery in Concord, Massachusetts,
She died 2 days after her father, Bronson.
Don't know. If they had a year, then maybe I would try. I'll try it, but I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to go for it.
The correct response is Louisa May Alcott.
Louisa May Alcott. I'll stay in there just in case we get something. 1600.
This author of Metamorphosis rests at a Jewish cemetery in Prague beneath a tombstone.
Oh, I'm going to try. I'm going to try to look that up on.
Okay, player one.
Metamorphosis. That's a book, I think. I don't know if it was a movie, E2. Metamorphosis writer. Oh, I got this. Who is Franz Kafka, if I'm saying that correctly? Booyah! 8800, Emmy.
Please.
2000. Oh, shit. Daily double. One of the two.
You are in the lead right now. What will it be?
Okay, let's just... You know what, I'm just gonna play it safe. We're gonna do 2000, Emily. We're gonna do 2000.
Answer. A little detective work in a Hampshire churchyard, and you'll find the grave of this patriot, physician, and man of letters.
Okay, patron. Patriot, physician, and man of letters. Patriot or patrian? Patriot. Alright. Patriot, physician, and man. Okay, let me make sure I'm spelling physician right. Man of letters. I got this. That's after the toilet flushing again, Emily. Sorry. My family's going to bed and about to, have a flush to go to the bathroom. Who is Arthur Conan Doyle? Yes, you got the Daily Double. Look at you dancing, Emily. Around the world for 1600.
The principalities of Moldavia and Wallachia were joined together to form this country in the 19th century. Here's the correct response. Romania.
Romania. Okay, get the hell out of there. I know there's only one thing left, but this is too much. One. I'll still pre the meaning of the prefix 800.
Die, as in dicephalus.
I get it just a second ago. I still don't get it, what this means.
Let's hear it, player three.
Old. No.
That's incorrect. Anyone else?
No. Does it mean death? I don't want to try it. Well, we have a big lead, so who cares? What is, open?
No.
Nope. Sorry. It's okay, we're still in the lead. We still got a big lead. It's two, isn't it?
Okay, player two.
Yep. Pretty obvious.
Selection, please, as we continue. Pink, red, or purplish, a port wine stain is a large one of these, usually on the face or neck.
Face or neck.
The correct response is a birthmark.
Birthmark. Ah, I was thinking about a bruise, so I kind of didn't try it.
Also called leukocytes, these blood cells defend the body against infection. Here's the response we were looking for. White cells. You get to pick again, player two. The dura mater is the outermost protective layer that covers the spinal cord and this organ.
I have no clue. Player two is going to try it. What is his brain? He got it. He's almost out of the hole.
Player two, back to you. Unfortunately, high cholesterol can lead to atherosclerosis,
in which these blood vessels become clogged.
Trying to see how much battery left on my cam. Battery's already getting low.
Okay, player three.
Hey, I'm gonna try to get this done fast as possible.
You've got some money again.
Yep, she's out of the hole.
A lot of clues, a lot of categories, player three.
Only three categories left, that's not a lot.
Survives a Luftwaffe attack and the annual flower show as the title misses in this film.
I'm gonna try to hurry this up as fast as possible. Miss Miniver. He's out of the hole, but this is kind of a runaway for now.
Lose a lot of categories, player two.
It's not a lot of categories. Now, shut up.
This Pacific Island Kingdom is Nuku'alofa.
Cool. It sounds Chinese or Japanese, but I'm not sure what the hell the answer is.
We're talking about Tonga.
Tonga. Wasn't even thinking about that.
You get
only six clues left.
Two. Contra.
Contra. The best way to get the correct answer, if you're not so sure, is if
the
computer will come with two wrong answers again. Two wrong answers, then you ring in and get the last one, and you know it wasn't picked yet.
Anti.
No, we're gonna try it, Emily. It doesn't hurt to guess. Before, during, or after? I'm gonna say during. What is during? Damn! 8,400. That's okay. Not during. It's probably before or after. It's probably after. I think I might have figured it out.
We're talking about before.
Oh, before. Okay.
Player two. Pick again.
Oh, great. All he can do is bet up to 2,000.
You're in last.
Oh, he's in 500. Okay. Say it with me again, Emily. Get it wrong. Oh, he got it. But it doesn't mean shit. It's only $1,100.
Please. Jimmy Stewart as Buttons the Clown upstages Charlton Heston in this three-ring affair from 1952.
Okay, you know, I'm going to try it. I'm going to look it up. Jimmy Stewart, Buttons the Clown. I'm just going to look up the character. Buttons the Clown. I want to make sure Jimmy Stewart's name is in there. There we go. I think I got this. What is the greatest show on earth? Yes! We're gonna get this done in time. 1600. There's no more Daily Doubles left.
Alcoholic Ray Milland is reminded that one's too many and a hundred's not enough in this film.
Don't know. The computer players need to not get these wrong in order to stay alive for Final Jeopardy.
Here's the correct response. Lost Weekend.
Lost Weekend. Here's the last clue. We're going to get this done plenty of time.
Now, the $2,000.
Last clue, Emmy. Here we go.
Gregory Peck gets the scoop on anti-Semitism in this film adapted by Moss Hart.
I don't even know.
The correct response is Gentleman's Agreement.
Gentleman's Agreement. Like those used in the NASCAR racing back to the flag.
We'll all be moving on to Final Jeopardy after this break.
Wow! The computer player survived. Landmarks.
What are you going to wait?
Yeah, I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to wager only 500. That's it. Okay, you know, yeah, I have to.
Now it's time for the final game.
I wasn't sure what the hell I was doing.
It is. Some of its
people, it's a bit run away anyway.
50 tons were quarried at Marlboro Downs, about 20 miles away.
It doesn't hurt to guess. You know what? I'm gonna say, what is London Bridge?
And your response? Sorry.
No, not Westminster Abbey. Wait, I'm still looks promising for you. I might get it right.
What did you say?
Buckingham Palace.
And
no!
Did you come up with the correct?
Let's see, Emily.
And that was
damn incorrect. But hey, you still won.
Here's what we were looking for.
Stonehenge. Damn. And you won, Emily! You won! It wasn't easy, but you did it. You're welcome, Alex. Bye. Good job, Emily. Good job. You did it. So there you have it, Emily. That's your 22nd birthday special for this year. My very first year being friends with you. Now I'm gonna try to make it as quick as possible because my camera is about to die. I want to have it for tomorrow at work if I see you. And I want to record your birthday, encore of you and your birthday song, and also take a picture with you and your guests I'm gonna give you. That was like one of the hardest Jeopardy video games I've ever played. For anything, like a birthday special or a Let's Play. I just enjoy playing video games all personally without me recording. But hey, you wasn't easy, but you won. That final Jeopardy was a no-brainer, so I just bet, well, I bet really little. No need to bet big, otherwise we're going to lose the game to a computer player who only has a little amount who didn't do well in Double Jeopardy. So you were off to a bad start in the Jeopardy round, might negative 2,000, but then you came back, took the lead, and then the computer player was off to a bad start in Double Jeopardy. Like, what the hell was that all about? But then all three of you came back, and only you finally made Final Jeopardy, and the right person won. You for your 22nd birthday. And so after I get done with this video, done making this, recording this, I'm gonna make you a card online. I'm gonna give you to tomorrow at work. And I'm also gonna give you another Austin Dillon picture for you to keep of one of his wins this year. So that way you can hang both pictures up on your bedroom wall and at your home. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that birthday video. And let's not forget, I hope that come next month for December during Christmas time that you, me, Shanta, and Nikki can do that Dick Clark video, just doing the Dick Clark walk. I know I won't post that on here because, depends on what they say, but I'll post it to Facebook, everybody can see, of us trying to do the Dick Clark walk, while singing Jingle Bell, I'm singing my version, the rest of you, or you really just singing the original, we have to do it without laughing. So we'll talk to Shanta and Nikki about it, and then we'll see what they say. But anyway, that's all I'm gonna say for now. Happy 22nd birthday, Emily. I hope you had a great day today. I'll see you tomorrow at work where I'll sing your birthday song and give you your gift and your card. Happy 22nd birthday. You're my best friend until the day I die. I love you. Go Austin and Ty.